For the most part, engineers are used to working in multiple unit systems, and they're generally pretty comfortable with it, using the different units and converting between them. But proper unit use and conversions are actually very important. There have been multiple famous engineering disasters over time that can actually be attributed to using or converting units improperly. For this reason, I want to share with you my fourth Excel tip that every engineer should know, the convert function. So let's say, just for a quick example, we want to convert a value of 2 inches to millimeters. Well, Excel has a great built-in feature that can easily do that. And all you need to feed it is a unit code, basically, and then the value you want to convert, and then it'll convert that for you. So if we go ahead and enter in that function right here, so we're gonna convert is the function here. Now, what is the number that we're going to convert, and then the from unit. So you can see it gives us a list of all these different units that Excel has built in, which is great. I can't think of any that are in here that an engineer might need to use that isn't actually in this list. So I think it's a pretty comprehensive list. It should have everything for the most part that you'd ever need as an engineer. So I'm going to convert from, my from unit is going to be the inches to millimeters. So if we just select those two cells and feed those two unit codes into the function, then we will get a value of 50.8 millimeters, which is exactly 2 inches. So another quick example, let's take a value of 10 psi and convert that to megapascals. And the convert function is actually case sensitive, and that's very important to know. We need to make sure that the code for the unit that we're using is entered correctly. So the capital M stands for mega, and then capital PA is the pascals. So if we use the convert function again, convert this 10 value from PSI to megapascals. So now that we looked at some examples, I just wanted to show you, I have this list of all the different codes that we have to use in this function. So you can see the unit type here, so weight and mass, we have grams, slugs, pounds, U, the atomic mass unit, and then ounce mass. And then we have distance, meter, yards, time, pressure, force, energy. So for pressure, we used pascals, even magnetism, temperature. And then down here, this is a list of the prefixes. So these prefixes can be used to actually modify the metric unit codes. So you could, for example, add a capital M in front of the G for grams to get megagrams or milligrams for the a lowercase m. So lots of different options there for units. I got this list from online, and then I just kind of customized it into my own nice little table here. And the reason for that is in the next video or in an upcoming video, I'm actually going to show you how to make a handy, I guess, unit converter utility where we can actually select, say from a dropdown, the unit type. So say we wanna work in weight and mass. So we'll select weight and mass first, and then we'll have two dropdowns for the units here where it'll only show us the available units based on that unit type category up there. So we'll dive into that in the next video, but I'm gonna show you how to make a nice little handy unit conversion sheet using Excel. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this valuable. I know a lot of people probably already knew about this one, but it's so handy that I just had to make a video about it. If you're not subscribed already, make sure to subscribe so you can get all my videos as they're released. I try to release a video every week or two, and make sure to share this video with all your engineering friends so they can check out this awesome tip as well. And remember, this channel is for you, so if you have any video suggestions, make sure to leave a comment down below and let me know what you all want to see. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.